in the states. They're the same. Some are considering the possibility of declaring bankruptcy. But our next guest says this should not be an option, and we need to find another way to deal with the fiscal crisis, including a balanced budget amendment. And that is what Senator John Cornyn, who joins us from Capitol Hill, is talking about today. Good morning to you, sir.
Morning, Steve.
We're going to put up a quotation from Eric Cantor from within the last week or two. He was queried whether or not, well, will Capitol Hill bail out the states? And effectively, he said, no, there won't be a bailout.
He's right, and there shouldn't be. If there was one message we got from this election on November the 2nd, is people are sick and tired of the federal government spending borrowed money. 42 cents on every dollar that has been spent recently has been borrowed money, and this is just unsustainable. We've got to stop it. So no more bailouts for the federal government, no more bailouts for state governments, and we need to let people work their own finances out, just like every family and small business does across America.
And we've got a map, Senator, that shows the states that are facing shortfalls, and it's a bunch of them. 46 of 50 are, and those are the ones that are in the red. So you and Senator Hatch are proposing a balanced budget amendment, which is the way people operate their own homes. You can't spend more than you take in.
Everybody in America, including state governments, 49 of them have a requirement of a balanced budget. And as you point out, every business, every family, when there's less money coming in the front door, then you can spend less money going out. And this just puts the federal government on the same terms that everybody else. And what we do is it's a constitutional amendment. It came within one vote of passing in 1997 when the budget deficit was about $100 billion. Yesterday, right, it was reported to be $1.5 trillion. So if it was a good idea then, and I think it was, it's even more compelling now given the state of our finances.
No kidding. You've got to figure you'd have more support. Hey, we had a Fox News alert yesterday that a suspicious package was received at your office in Dallas. What was it?
Well, apparently it was not dangerous, and the police responded immediately. That my staff, I'm very proud of them. They were acting with, keeping their eyes open and looking for suspicious packages. But obviously everyone is much more careful in this post-Tucson environment than maybe we were before. So I'm glad for the sake of my staff and constituents, they did the right thing and the police took care of it.
No kidding. All right. Well, Senator Cornyn, we know that even though the D.C. schools are closed today, Capitol Hill is open and ready for business, so you better get to work.
Absolutely. Thanks, Steve.
All right. Thanks for dropping by. All right. More Fox and Friends from a snowy New York City. Back in 2 and 2.